With your latest news, I'm April Cummings. The government of the Cayman Islands signs a public-private sector partnership with DART to address the island's waste management issues.
I am most pleased today to announce the signing of a 25-year contract between the Cayman Islands government and DART to design, build, finance, maintain, and operate a new integrated solid waste management system and to complete the ongoing remediation of the Georgetown landfill.
Premier the Honourable Alden McLaughlin there making the announcement at a press conference held just 3 weeks before the general election. In attendance, the Minister of Health and Environment, representatives from government and DART.
We have been grappling with this problem of Mount Trashmore as a government and as a community for many, many years. Locally, the conversation surrounding our landfills, especially that of the Georgetown landfill, has been about finding solutions to a number of environmental and social issues, and of course, to the view.
Health Minister the Honourable Dwayne Seymour says the project promises 9 integrated facilities with the capacity of diverting up to 95% of the waste from the landfill. Those projects include an energy recovery facility, a green waste facility, a vehicle and scrap metal end-of-life processing facility, and household waste recycling centre.
We now have the Cayman Islands' first energy recovery facility, a complete transformational change to handling of waste in the Cayman Islands. This is all in line with the national waste hierarchy: reduce, reuse, recycle, recover, and dispose.
Officials say the remediation of the North Mound at the Georgetown landfill is scheduled for completion in 2022 and the regen facilities operational in 2024. The website for the project is live now, so you can get more information at regen.ky. Chief Fire Officer Paul Walker says crews remain on the scene of the Georgetown landfill fire, along with crews from the Department of Environmental Health, excavating and ensuring there are no flare-ups from Thursday morning's fire, which caused some road closures along the Esterly-Tibbetts Highway overnight. Mr. Walker says there's still no word yet on the cause of the fire, but the matter is under investigation. Chief Medical Officer Dr. John Lee reports 4 positives from the 484 COVID-19 tests carried out since Thursday. The individuals are all travelers who tested positive following routine screening, and they will remain in isolation until considered recovered. The number of people in isolation, whether at a government facility or in their homes, as required by the Medical Officer of Health, is 931. So far, 45,673 COVID-19 vaccines have been administered to date, and 44% of the estimated population has received at least one dose of the Pfizer-BioNTech vaccine. 26% has completed the 2-dose course. The results include 606 additional injections, which have been provided over the last few weeks in the sister islands, which had not previously been reported. The Police Association says the commissioner has been served with another formal letter before action for alleged unlawful decisions in relation to failures in the administration of promotions within the Royal Cayman Islands Police Service. Radio Cayman's Paula Cal has more.
The LBA claims that the current improper and unfair system of promotions by the commissioner is in breach of his legal obligations and is contrary to the Public Services Management Law and personnel regulations. The Police Association says the commissioner, quote, has and continues to misuse his powers under the police law. In the first instance, the Police Association says officers has been appointed by the commissioner to acting roles and remain in these roles longer than the 12-month statutory time limit, with some officers remaining in acting roles, quote, for up to nearly 4 years. The Police Association says there are currently officers who have been appointed to and remain in acting roles in excess of the 12-month statutory time limit. The consequence of this is that reportedly other officers who have passed the promotion examination from as far back as 2007 have been denied an opportunity to be promoted to these roles. The second issue relates to the promotion board. The association says there are 57 constables who have passed the promotion to sergeant examination and 16 sergeants who have passed the promotion to inspector examination who are all awaiting an opportunity to be interviewed by the promotion board. However, the LBA claims none of the acting positions have been advertised during the last 3 years and no scheduled dates have been set for a promotion interview board to be convened. For Radio Cayman News, I am Paula Cal.
Radio Cayman's request for response from the commissioner was not received as of our deadline. Plans are underway for the Central Business District Enhancement Project. Radio Cayman's Felicia Rankin-Sollins has more.
Three phases, a collaborative effort by the Ministry of Commerce Planning and Infrastructure Core Team, National Roads Authority, Caribbean Utilities Company, and Transportation Civil Engineers, all to make Grand Cayman's capital a nicer place to be.
You're changing the surface of the road to a brick, more cooler surface. We're adding lighting. We're upgrading underground structure in terms of utility. And we're adding furniture and landscaping. So in essence, we're adding some what we call pocket parks. Part of Cardinal Avenue now will be a park. And also in front of the post office, we've pulled the road away from the post office because all those areas was deemed unsafe.
Georgetown Manager Revitalization Initiative Coordinator Colin Lumsden explains, phase one will be to upgrade Cardinal Avenue. The second phase will take place at the intersection adjacent to the post office at Edward Street, Cardinal Avenue, and Main Street. And similar work is proposed to take place in the third phase of the project on Main Street.
We've also highlighted a more smoother, smart pedestrian pattern around the Central Business District. So instead of having hodgepodge of traffic crossings at very, like, sometimes even unsafe areas, we've regularized it, and we've also highlighted those pedestrian areas. They're going to pop out in terms of them being a colored surface. The main focus was on pedestrians.
For Radio Cayman News, I'm Felicia Rankin-Solins.
The project is expected to start in June and run for 6 months. A local preschool makes satisfactory progress in addressing several recommendations from the Office of Education Standards. Radio Cayman's Carsley Fuller has more.
During the follow-through inspection of Precious Gems Preschool that took place earlier this month, the team worked to assess how the school had done to improve areas of concern identified in a November 2019 inspection. Inspectors have evaluated that progress made by the preschool leaders in addressing all six recommendations was satisfactory. They include review and improve the programs for well-being and communication to facilitate child's progress, particularly in the kindergarten classes, review assessment practices across the center to ensure that assessment information is comprehensive and is used effectively to inform the children's next steps in learning, enhance the quality of teaching and learning by providing professional development for staff in the area of positive behavior, amend the structure of the typical day to maximize children's practical hands-on learning time, address the health and safety issues identified in the previous report, and improve leadership through the introduction of more rigorous and accurate self-evaluation arrangements and comprehensive record-keeping systems. There will be no further follow-through inspection of Precious Gems, as the preschool will now join the regular cycle of inspections. Reporting for Radio Cayman News, I'm Kirstley Fuller.
The Miss World Cayman Islands pageant is on Saturday, May 29th at the Harquail Theater. And each Friday, we are putting the spotlight on the contestants. This week, Radio Cayman's Shanda Gallego catches up with contestant number 3, 25-year-old Sidoni Barrett, representing Georgetown.
I heard you have a bachelor's in law. Why was it important for you to get into law, and what has that been like for you?
Yes, so my bachelor is in law with international studies. So with that degree and that bachelor's, I was able to combine my two interests of law and international relations and politics. So that was really important to me to find that degree that combined that. But also I've known from a young age that I've wanted to be a lawyer, and I've always felt that I've had the skill set for it. But I've also just known that it's a really great career to make an impact from, especially within Cayman Islands. And, you know, that's really important to me.
And I did a little bit more digging up. You're the first Caymanian to enter and win Miss Caribbean UK.
Yes.
Tell us about that. What was interesting about that experience?
So I entered Miss Caribbean UK because I've known for a few years I've wanted to enter a national pageant here. So I was studying in the UK and decided to enter a pageant there just as kind of a practice. And lo and behold, my first pageant I won. So it was an amazing opportunity to be the first Caymanian to enter it and win. Yeah,
that's
so
crazy.
Forever grateful for that opportunity.
Let's switch gears. The Miss World Cayman Islands pageant. What made you decide to enter the pageant in the first place?
Entering Miss World Cayman Islands was very important to me because of that idea of being an ambassador. I've always wanted to represent my country on a international stage, and this will afford me that opportunity if I do win. And also to be a role model for the younger generation. I've always been heavily involved in the community. When I was in high school, I was in Key Club, and I would go on Saturdays to the Georgetown Primary School and read to little kids. So that's very important to me to have that that involvement in the community and to be a role model for the younger kids. So those are some of the main reasons I entered Miss World Cayman Islands, but also because of what it represents. The platform for Miss World is beauty with a purpose, and I like that it doesn't only focus on your beauty, but also like your community involvement, your engagement with charities and local organizations.
That's Miss World Cayman Islands contestant number 3, Sidoni Barrett. The pageant again is on Saturday, May 29th at the Harkwell, starting at 6 p.m. Reigning queen J.C. Patrick will crown her successor at the grand finale. That is your latest local news from Radio Cayman's newsroom. I'm April Cummings.